Hazard identification and risk assessment. Welcome back in this lecture. In this lecture, we will explore the methods of identifying hazards and assessing risk. Understanding these processes is essential for maintaining safety and preventing accidents in the workplace. Hazard identification and risk assessment are crucial for ensuring safety in any work environment. By identifying potential hazards and assessing the associated risk, we can take proactive measures to protect workers and maintain smooth operation. What is hazard identifications? So, hazard identification is a process of recognizing hazards that could cause harm. Objective of identifying hazard is the main goal is to proactively identify potential source of danger. Types of hazards. Hazards can be physical, chemical, biological, ergonomic or electrical. There are several techniques for identifying hazards. It includes workplace inspection. Regular inspection helps to identify unsafe conditions. Second one is job safety analysis or JSA, breaking down tasks to identify risks. Third one is incident investigation, analyzing past incident to prevent reoccurrence. Fourth one is safety audits, comprehensive review of safety practices and conditions. And the last one is employee reporting, encouraging workers to report hazards. Each of these methods provide valuable insight into the potential hazards in the workplace. What is risk assessment? Now let us talk about risk assessment. Risk assessment is the process of evaluating the risk associated with the identified hazards. The objective is, or the aim is, to determine the likelihood and severity of harm. Components. The main components of risk assessments are hazard identification, risk analysis, and risk evaluation. Risk assessment process. The risk assessment process involves several steps. It includes, the first one is identify hazard, recognize potential source of harm. Second one is analyze risks, evaluate the likelihood and impact of each hazard. The third one is evaluate risk, determine the level of risk and prioritize actions. Fourth one, control measures, implement measures to mitigate risks. Fifth one, monitor and review, continuous monitor and update risk assessment. This systematic approach helps to ensure that all potential risks are adequately addressed. Risk analysis techniques. There are various methods of conducting risk analysis. It includes qualitative analysis, using descriptive terms to evaluate risk. Second one is quantitative analysis, using numerical data and statistical methods. Third one, semi-quantitative analysis, combining qualitative and quantitative approaches. Fourth one, common tools. Risk matrix, agreed to assess and prioritize the risks. Second one, failure modes and effects analysis, FEMA. Systematic evaluation of potential failure. Hazard and operability study, HAJOP, identifying hazards and operability problems. Each of these techniques provide different insight and level of detail for assessing risks. Risk evaluation. When evaluating risk, consider some criteria. First one is likelihood. How often hazard could occur? Second one, severity. The potential impact of hazard. Third one, risk level. Combination of likelihood and severity. Fourth one, prioritization. addressing the most significant risk first. This helps in effectively prioritizing and managing risk. Control measures. Implementing control measure is essential for risk assessment. It includes elimination, removing the hazard entirely. Second one, substitution, replacing the hazard with less dangerous option. The third one, engineering control, isolating people from the hazard. The fourth one, administrative controls, changing work practices and procedures. And the last one is PPEs or personal protective equipment, using personal protective equipment or protective gear to reduce risk. These measures help in mitigating risk and adhering or ensuring a safe work environment. Continuous monitoring and review. The ongoing risk management is crucial for maintaining safety. It includes regular reviews, periodical reassessing risk and control measures. Second one is incident reporting, updating assessment based on new information. Third one is training and awareness, keeping employees informed and trained. Fourth one is documentation, maintaining detailed record of assessments and action taken. Continuous monitoring and review ensure that risk management practices remains effective and up to date. To summarize, hazard identification and risk assessment are essential for workplace safety. Various methods and techniques can be used to identify hazards and assess risk. Implementing control measures and continuous monitoring are key to effective risk management. Thanks for joining this lecture on hazard identification and risk assessment. In the next module, we will discuss practical application of these processes in your workplace. Stay tuned and stay safe. Please remember, proactive hazard identification and thorough risk assessment are most important for maintaining a safe and efficient work environment. Always prioritize safety in all operations.